name is Sanan Man. So our project is stock market price prediction using news sentiment analysis. The group details are our group number is 26. I am Harshisha, he is Darshan Patel and she is Vivekha Kumar. And we have done this project under the guidance of Professor Prachi Panchal. So the scope of the presentation would be, first we would go through the introduction, the objective of the project, what is the related background, expected outcome present technology. Then we'll tell you how the data we explored and the methodology of the project. And then the web demo and conclusion. So the introduction. Now, stock market prices tend to change very fast. And they're quite volatile. We don't know that when will it change and what will it change. Because just by going through the values, we can predict it. Because there is also a term called new sentiment related to it. So if we can find the reasons on the basis of which the prices are changing, how the indices of the Sensex and Nifty change, then predict the approximate future price, and it would be of great help. We can generate loads of money through it.
So let's see what
we like stock trading. That's the reason that we chose this project.
Synopsis, I was thinking you guys must be doing more.
Yeah,
all three of you.
Yes.
When you generate
good
money, you give us this
too. Sure.
Sure? We're recording.
Yeah.
Okay,
sure.
Go ahead.
So, now stock prices depend on a variety of factors like market sentiment, company decisions, politics of the country. When we go through the market sentiment, like now if we go for the stock price of Jet Airways, then we know that it is definitely going to be down. If Nirav Modi gets arrested in London, the price of BNB increases by 4%. So that is the market sentiment of a specific company. Now the company decisions and the results of the company. Whenever a company generates its result, the prices of the stock tend to change. Now the politics of the country. When we go for the politics of the country, we can see that when the number of seats BJP gets increases, the stock market goes up and vice versa. It is the general trend right now. Then the economic environment of the country, pumping and dumping and many more things. Pumping and dumping generally happens in the penny stocks.
Happens where?
In penny stocks. Because now there are no big whales in India who can pump and dump like in the shares like Infosys and Jet. They are quite high price. So also from the past, we can get to know the trend of the stocks from the past data which we have, and we can also get through that we can get an idea of how the stock gets to a particular condition by looking at the previous data. So our objective is to help one take smarter and intelligent decisions while investing. So if one wants to invest and if one has a basic outlook that what would be its price in future, even if it's the closing price of today, then we can do better intraday decisions. We can take better intraday decisions. So the literature review
helps you in intraday as well.
Yes. Basically, we predict the upcoming closing price of the stock.
Intraday and also the future. This model will help me.
At present, we are predicting the upcoming closing price.
Upcoming?
Closing price of the stock.
For intraday.
Yeah, for the specific day.
Specific day.
Yeah.
Specific day, the closing price.
Yes. So, we have took references from three papers. Based on them, we developed our model.
Data set you are providing. If you are providing data set of the cryptocurrency, it will work out for the cryptocurrency also.
Okay, so which data set is
this? Yeah. We are taking from NSE.
But you tried cryptocurrencies as well?
Yeah, in the previous semester I tried. The first reference is also my research paper.
So did you get, because it's interesting. So I'm sure you must have, after this model, you must have tried. Validated your result with the actual
future.
Yes. For the trend prediction, we are 95.23% for trend prediction. Whether the price will be go up or down.
So you are 95% accurate.
Yes.
In the intonation of the, like, the price will be go up or down. For the specific exact price, it was just 2 to 3 rupee change. First.
Like which you were able to predict?
Yeah, RMSE is 0.09.
Okay, and did you guys find any other model available today in the...
During our literature review, what we saw that the different types of model present in the market, they just predicted whether it will go up or down.
Okay, but not predicting the actual price.
If we are predicting actual price, they use only stock data, not previous sentiment.
They used only the previous data of stock available. They didn't use new sentiment. So we combined both.
Okay, but that means this is the first of a kind the thing you guys are doing. It's not available today, this particular model.
Up to our knowledge, this is the first of its kind.
You can make some changes in that and you can go for the credit.
Yeah.
So this is the, you know, this is you have to submit to the institute, so you can't go ahead.
But we believe in Sarvajan Hitaay, Sarvajan Sukhaay. Let everyone earn the money.
Just like, you know, that Linus told that the
yeah.
open source.
Let everyone earn the money. So the expected outcome of our project is we have developed it would like the expected outcome was a web app and a telegram bot which when provided with the name of a script would give an approximate prediction of the next closing price of the stock and by analyzing the market sentiments of course because that is the differentiating factor of our project. Now the tools and technology we used are for IT we have used Spider, the libraries are Keras, Scikit-learn and text block for sentiment analysis. Trust for deployment, NSCPY for getting the stock data. And the, for API, we use Telegram API. So we have developed both on a web app also and a Telegram bot also.
Methodology, we have used the attributes we have used is the opening price, closing price, high price, low price, adjusted close, and the volumes and the twist sentiment. Based on the above mentioned price, we are predicting the next closing price, next working day closing price of that stock. Design the flowchart of implementation. First, we collected the data, stock data, and the new sentiment. Then, cleaning and pre-processing was done. This is the data gathering. NSE file library has already implemented the scraping of the National Stock Exchange website. So, we have directly used that to get the data. And then for market sentiment, we have used Twitter API to get the tweets.
For the Twitter, you have particular
keyword,
ID, right?
Keyword. Yeah, like financial, multiple keywords we have given. Like one is the stock data, means for which stock we are predicting. So stock name, then the finance and the current affairs keyword. This is the data explosion. Sample data will look like this. We have collected nearly 5 years of data. So total rows is of 1,217 and it increases day by day.
Because market does not work all the days. Only Monday to Friday. Friday does the market work.
Why Twitter? I asked. Why only Twitter? You consider
Twitter? Twitter gives the 10% of public available tweets to us.
Why are you not considering Facebook? From there also.
Like Twitter is an official handle. Like now each and every company, everyone has their global presence on Twitter. And Twitter is nowadays very common in the corporate world also.
And Facebook has a restricted API usage.
So here we have more.
Yes, for getting more data, we have used Twitter. And for Indian stock, they are not available API for the news. For foreign stocks like S&P 500, they are New York Times API for the news data.
Okay. So your train data is on NSE data you said, right?
Yes.
So your model should help if you have foreign stocks, if you have such data, it should.
Yeah, foreign stocks, we can go through Yahoo Finance.
What I question is, like, so this model is based on the train data.
Yes.
If my train data is for a different country or a different currency, based on that your model it will work or it will be changes here?
We just have to change the API. Like data gathering
API.
Okay,
API. Your privacy tutor is best you thought.
Yes.
But if it is something else, you say now we don't
like for USA, for getting new sentiments, there is New York Post API. But now the news of Indian companies won't come there. And India does not have any Indian newspaper, any Indian newspaper does not have such API. So we had to use
Twitter. Twitter can't be used for your
company. Yeah, it can be used.
It can be used, but New York Post can also be used because that newspaper has itself its own API.
It's a
so you might have multiple sources of
yes.
Right?
New York Times is better.
Able to consider that multiple sources of information.
Yes.
If we can do that, to take today,
multiple
sources?
Today, right now only Twitter.
Only Twitter, okay.
Yes.
India does not have any other API.
This is the data visualization. We are generating using the matplotlib library available in Python. Calculated average and high low prices of the Bajaj Auto price, Bajaj Auto stock. This is the price and trend graph. How the price is trending up or down. Then the opening and closing price of the Bajaj Auto finance.
And this is the actual data, right? What you are showing me is the
actual data. Yes,
actual data. Actual data. This
is the implementation flow of the algorithm. We have used LSTM for that. First, we gathered the data.
LSTM?
Long short-term memory. Long short-term memory. It is a specialized algorithm for the RNA. Recurrent neural network. So first, we have the data selection, then the data pre-processing, like the data normalization and training test split. Then hyperparameter tuning for the LSTM, like the batch size, number of epochs, loss function. Then the training process will be begun and evaluate it with the test data. And if the data is satisfactory, we go for the testing data and finalize the model parameters. And then we can predict the future price. This is the architecture of LSTM, normal architecture of LSTM. In the middle one, the deep architecture of the LSTM will be displayed. There is a XT is the input data and HT line is the memory lane. So gate in the LSTM is the three type of input gate, forget gate and output gate. Input gate gives the data to the forget gate decide how.
Can you explain this in example?
With example?
So basically input gate gets the data. Now forget gates remembers only the data which is needed, means which is useful.
Using selective read and write operations.
Yeah, it removes the irrelevant data.
And then the
data
should be kept.
So as the name suggests, it forgets the data which it does not need.
This is the architecture of our model. LSTM followed by dropout of 0.2. It means 20% of the row will be removed randomly to overcome the overfitting problem.
Randomly you are removing
them? Yes, dropout. To remove overfitting problem. Like we have 100 data points, and if we train our whole data for the number of epochs 100, then algorithm memorize all the data. So training accuracy will be higher, like nearly 100%, but testing accuracy will be suffered, like 50% or 40%.
So you want to have only 70% of training data, that's why you have yourself. Why you don't need 100% of data?
Means it is a type of cross validation. We do not take the same data again and again for testing. For training the model, we don't take the same data again and again. Because if it comes, then our accuracy here it will show 100%. But when we actually test it, then it won't show. So that's why
actually, the whole data set will be used. It is all the one epoch. If we are using 100 epoch, then the remaining data can be trained. Like in the first epoch, last 20 rows will be removed, and the next epoch, first 20 rows will be removed.
You are randomly
using
the percentage of data.
Yes.
Almost 20%.
Okay. And
then
the last
that you will be using for your test data.
For the training data.
20%
will be
for test data. 80%
is training.
The
rest 20%. Validation set. For the validating. Last layer is the dense with the activation function sigmoid.
Last one is what?
A dense layer with activation function sigmoid.
Okay.
Sigmoid function will give the probability between 0 to 1. So after denormalized data, we can get the future price. This is our performance of our model. Root mean square error is 0.00098. Mean absolute percentage error is only 6.61%. and the accuracy of predict range is 95.23%. Our graph shown is the actual price and the our predicted price for the 200 days.
For 200 days, yes. You are giving a prediction.
It is for the testing.
This is for Bajaj Auto.
Okay. X-axis is stage. Okay. That's the actual,
what's
the
value of stock price?
Yes.
Stock price.
Yeah, in the
Y-axis. The Y-axis is the stock price and the X-axis is the date.
Okay.
So this is the trend prediction.
1 by 2 for 1 year, 1 year. Yes. First May 2018 to 31st May 2018. Okay. So this is how our main web page looks like, and the whole predict, about, and contact are the so. It's a single page only. So we first enter the stock data which we want to predict. Then we check, we get the, means we click on the get stock data. So then after that, it fetches the data of HDFC bank, for example, that we have selected. Then we click on get news data. So it fetches that news data also. By combining both of them, then we click on train. So it will train and give the MSE and the train score and RMSE for the news and the the stock data and the news data. For both of them it will give that. Then and output of the prediction function, it will give the closing price. After means we have to click the predict, then it will give the next closing price.
Who will be the user of this application?
Anyone doing stock market.
Okay, then why do you need to do all this?
It is online.
I'm a user. I don't want to. I just want to know the stock name. I mean,
yeah. In the
why
future,
are you going to get the data? Then the news data. Trend,
like this is
trend,
for presenting to the technical person that this is how step by step everything will be done. And user when
this is your application.
Yes.
Okay. Snapshot of your
application. Yes.
Finally,
yes.
You click on predict and you will get the.
You have another application for great user.
Yes, that is on Telegram. You just have to write the name of the stock.
This is for the presentation purpose. So, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. This is an online learning model, so every day model will be learned. Model will be trained every day using the new data.
Okay. This is to show the technical team how it is done.
Yes.
Yeah. So when we create the final app, like if we go into the market and create it for the user, then they don't have to even give on the predict function. They just have to select the stock.
Yeah.
Yes,
and the prediction will be given.
Can you show me
the
other?
This is
the best of purpose?
Yes.
This is the conclusion that our RMSE is
0.09.
Can
you show me the
other?
Telegram.
Telegram.
Yes.
Mobile.
It's a mobile app.
Yeah.
Telegram.
On Telegram.
Okay. Telegram. So, mobile app.